doing it wrong, and please stop.
Home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly, as they get ready to match up with Philip Rivers and the Los Angeles Chargers. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Looking right. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Right back to him on first down. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Now they try the right side here, and he works free. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, LA. A big play there. 57 yards, and the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. You talk about explosion plays, there's one pretty much right out of the gate.
And now they get to ride a wave of emotion, momentum, everything. Just as you described, right out of the gate, big sprint, touchdown, they're excited. But on the other side, they've got to guard against a major letdown because they hit them right in the gut with that one. And now you start to question yourself a little bit when you give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Carry for Wendell Smallwood. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Now Foles looking deep for his tight end Ertz. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Casey Hayward, and his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. And Charles, I've got to give credit to the Chargers because you finished 12-4, second-best record in the AFC, but you find yourself in the wild card game. You traveled across country and play in a 10 a.m. start for them if you consider West Coast time, but they found a way to beat Baltimore.
They certainly did, and they were the first team to see Lamar Jackson, the quarterback for Baltimore, twice. And that helped them because they limited him for most of the ball game. Didn't totally shut him down, but made it very difficult for him. Now, how about this? 9-0 this season in games in which they've had to board a plane are the Chargers. And that includes a home game in London. The only loss? They took a bus cross town to play the Los Angeles Rams.
Interesting. And their playoff lives continue. We'll see how they fare this week. Give him two on that run, and they're still left looking at a third and about 9 to go. And on the ground they go with the running back. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And he works his way forward for about 4 up to the midfield stripe.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now a handoff looking right. The 20, and they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down.
And it is still early, just the first quarter, but you start prorating the numbers and we might be in for some history. I mean, that last run puts him over 100 yards already, and we've still got 3 quarters to go.
Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
He'll get 4 yards of the carry there, and we will get to the end of the first quarter of play. Back now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Chargers here with a football. They're on the march, but facing a 3rd down here.
Here you go, man. Load it. Load it. Reload.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a pickup of 4, but they're still a yard short here with 4th down forthcoming.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation, and I thought he was going to get the 1st down the way the play developed, but the defense closed in and stopped him just about a yard short.
The Chargers will bring out the field goal unit now. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And his kick is indeed good. And the lead moves to 10-0. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. Football going back over to Philadelphia here, and this is a team who 6 weeks ago really looked lost, but then they won 5 of their last 6 to get to the 6th and final playoff spot, and then they defeat Chicago on the road.
Yeah, Nick Foles, he did it again, didn't he? Who would have thought that he would have to hop back in as he did last season and help carry this team not just to the playoffs, but get a win in the first round in Chicago in a cold weather game? How about Nick Foles? He just keeps doing it. Now they've got to go to New Orleans to take on the number one seeded New Orleans Saints.
And only 2 number 6 seeds have ever won the Super Bowl. Steelers in 05 and the Packers in 2010. They're trying to become number 3. Here's Foles. It's complete to Golden Tate. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Foles. And complete to Zach Ertz. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Here we go.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. The first carry for Josh Adams. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Denzel Perryman there to bring him down.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
They'll drop the throw. And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Joey Bosa coming in to drop him for a loss of 8. And it'll be 4th down. Two minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Defensively, a bit of a collapse, allowing the 4th down play to result in 23 yards. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's Melvin Ingram on the tackle.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Good for an Eagles first down. Wentz hooking up with Jeffrey.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off, okay? So they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is.
And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Josh Adams, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. Elliott Good with a PAT, and that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. Elliott now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Oh, Leeson behind on the spin. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him.
Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by Corey Graham. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. CD, one thing you and I haven't discussed now that we are in the playoffs, now we know how the start of the draft is going to go. You look at the top five, Arizona, San Fran, Jets at 3, Raiders, wherever they may be at 4, Tampa Bay 5. What are your thoughts?
Well, immediately, this is going to be different in 2019 than 2018, because in 2018, it was all about the quarterbacks. I don't think that's going to be the case. You just mentioned the top five. You can make a legitimate case that in the top five, none of those teams are in the market to select a quarterback. So now, who is? I think you got to get to number 6 with the New York Giants. That's where the quarterback market begins.
He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Golden Tate in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly for 6. And just before the half ends, the prayer is answered defensively. A disaster there.
I know often we're surprised when this actually works. I mean, the excitement level goes way up, but maybe we shouldn't be, because I know as a defender, you've got to play the ball in this situation, but you can't interfere with the receiver because, remember, it's a spot foul, and it'd be first and goal if it happens in the end zone. And you don't want to give up that play, and that little bit of hesitancy often works really well for offensive guys.
The Chargers offense gets set. They head back onto the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. An abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter 3. So we've come to halftime here in Philly with the Eagles on top. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and take. On play action, they'll throw. It's brought in left side by Tate. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that is incomplete. Golden Tate, his intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Melvin Ingram in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And this is taken in at the 5. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Well, they just treated 3rd and long as simply an opportunity to make an even bigger play. Normally, you're just trying to pick up the 1st down and you know where the sticks are. They took this thing way downfield. Confidence in the receivers to go up and make a play, even with defenders around them.
Let's go! Girl. Hey, go! Down goal!
They'll run with Smallwood, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up 2nd and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that...
And he's in! Touchdown, Eagles! Wendell Smallwood, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. Elliott Good on the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game. Elliott now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And it fights through one man. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now a look at the Chargers offense. They get ready for their first possession of the 2nd half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run, these things worked well for us, and sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. So now they have to contend with 2nd and 13 after the 1st down run goes backwards. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Corey Graham brings him down.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Here is the punter, Jones, as he gets this one away. Now Sproles. Sproles so quick and agile. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
Tiger! Tiger!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up. They're going to look to throw. Screen pass to Sproles. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on 4th. Looking to throw. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Jahleel Adai. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. So Rivers will lead the Chargers up 1st and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48.
Hey, Delta!
Following the interception here, Rivers. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Call it a gain of 5, and it'll make it 2nd down.
Hurry up! Left, left, left! Cluster, cluster, cluster!
Now they'll run it on the toss. Just a gain of 1 yard there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
And they'll go on the ground. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there, and a Charger first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few.
And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen, 32 yards. And the Chargers have made this a one-score game. And now we've got a stoppage here. The noise is deafening. They'll say what? A timeout. Boy, you could barely hear the whistles, but the offense does take a timeout here. So now a big play coming up as the Chargers are going to go for 2.
Four down.
They're going to try and run. And he will get into the end zone as a 2-point conversion is successful. And the lead is down to a field goal here in the 4th. So just a 3-point game now as they send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chile on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, he picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now?
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. And that one results in 35 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. They'll look to throw here on first down. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. Out of the gun now on third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. This is caught. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. So first and goal. 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. They'll go to Adams, try to pound it in. And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Josh Adams, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles add on to their lead. And the lead will grow by one more. Elliott now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. Able to spin free. And he's all the way up across the 40 and down at the 42-yard line. Great return.
There's no downplaying that we all knew that this was a critical possession. And to get a return like that to start things off, that's the spark that they needed. That's the spark they were looking for.
Chargers in good field position to start out. First and 10. Now they try the right side here. And an alley to run. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That good for 22 and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
And a short gain down to about the 33. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Now the Chargers hustling, trying to get up and get set. Now a handoff looking right. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Charger first. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now they try the right side here. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it's...
Oh, no, he lost the football, and the Eagles have recovered.
Well, that drive wasn't a case of wanting to put points on the board. It was needing to, having to, and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done, and now you look at the situation and the point differential, 2 scores, pretty much game, set, match.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defensive guys?
That one looks like he'll throw here. And he is out of bounds. Rams able to get it across the 20-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 12, and that should just about wrap this one up.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Back to throw here. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Desmond King there on the coverage.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Trevor Williams with a pick, and he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you could hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turned to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Whether it's a touchdown or a field goal, whatever it is, they need to score quickly here on first down.
Cluster.
Now a handoff looking right. And they'll get him down right around the 16. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. Now they try the right side here. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
What we're seeing from the defense here is a group of guys bearing down, trying to help out their quarterback after he threw an interception. Good stops on the first two downs. It brings up a key third down.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. A great play there with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chargers capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6. Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. They'll try and run it here. And he got it on the touchdown run, but he won't get in here. He'll be stopped short, and they'll come up empty on the try for 2. And the Eagles are going to recover. And that might be enough to put a bow on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time, you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
The Eagles in the victory formation as they take a knee. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long.
Tempo.
They'll set up a throw. Going for the deep ball. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over.
A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11 with three or four home runs mixed in.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long from Philadelphia.
He's in the room.